Hello, my name is Jan, and in this video I would like to give you a short introduction into Tolgee platform and how you can use it to translate your app into different human languages. Tolgee is a tool, is a platform helping companies to translate their apps into different human languages. It is pretty developer-centric and it has like the native integrations, which you can also integrate into your app, the code of your app, or the CLI, which you can use for automating the processes of getting the strings into Tolgee and exporting them back into your code base. But in this video, I would like to just show you the Tolgee platform itself and not these tools around, just how you can use the Tolgee platform. So this can be also an introduction for translators and other team members who somehow manage the strings, the wording, and overall the strings and the labels in the application. First thing you will see when you open Tolgee platform is this login page. I'm going to use GitHub login because I'm signed via GitHub, so I don't have to fill my password in. I get directly to the organization page where I can see a list of my projects, but so far I have no project created. So let's start with creating a simple project. In this video and also in the future videos, I will work with application which is a list to pack for some trip. So it's a demo application I will use. So for this project, I will use the name packing app, for example. And I will translate my packing app into German. So I will use German with the tag DE and Spanish, for example. I can choose from super many languages here, or I can even create my custom language. But for this case, we can stick with these three. I can hit save. And here I have the project created. Currently, there's nothing interesting. It's just empty project. So I can see there is like no keys in the project, no base words, and the status for each language is just zero. Everything is untranslated. So first thing to do is to basically fill the project with some data. In this case, for this demo, I will use this import feature. So as you can see, I can use import to import from many formats, but for this case, I'm going to import my English JSON. So what I'm going to do is import the file. And yeah, we don't care about anything here, basically. So I'm going to import it. As you can see, my data is imported. And now when I'm going to go to translations view, I can see all of the data here. I didn't provide the translation for German or for Spanish. I just imported the English file. So now, as you can see, I don't have any translations to German or Spanish. We can fix this. It depends on your process in your company or on your project workflow, but you can choose from multiple ways how you actually can translate your project into different languages. First option is to invite human translators or people you know to translate your project. You can use your community or whatever. And for this case, the translators will basically go and translate all the entries here. So let me show you the translation controlling elements. So when I click on the string, on the German version, for example, it's currently empty. And in the right side of the application, I can see some panels helping me with the translation. The first thing I see is the machine translation suggestions. I can see multiple suggestions from multiple providers. And for this case, all are the same. So I can, for example, use the translation from the Tolgee provider by clicking it. So that's basically it. And I can see some more tools. Now when I hit save, I have it saved. Apart from machine translation suggestions, I can see also some translation memory results, which are currently empty because there's nothing else translated to German, so it's empty. And I can see comments. So for example, when I'm a proofreader and I want to say that there is an error, I can say this is wrong, for example. And here you can see that there is a highlighted number one. There is one comment now, and I can hit also this resolve button, which means that the comments are resolved, and now the number is not highlighted. It It's just gray as here, but it's visible that there is nothing important. Human translation is not the fastest option. The fastest option, how to get everything translated, and probably the more interesting option for all, is to get it translated using machine translation, right? So here I can click to check all. Now I had everything selected, I can choose machine translation from the batch operations menu, and I can select the German and Spanish. I can hit this play button, and now everything is getting machine translated using the primary machine translation provider, which is by default Tolgee translator. As you can see, everything is translated now. I can also see this flag, which is telling me that everything was translated automatically with Tolgee translator. So this is the machine translation. Now, for example, as a proofreader or reviewer for the project, I can hit this reviewed button, which changes basically the state of the translation to reviewed. So I can review multiple translations. And here in the project dashboard now, I can see some more interesting stats. So I can see the overall stats that 88% translations are translated, which means they are in the translated state, and there are 12% reviewed. Cool. Then I can see the state for each language. So I can see that for German, there is 9% reviewed and 91% is in the translated state. Also, I can see the activity log, so I can see that myself did a lot of stuff on the project. I can see each of the operations I did on the project here in the activity log. There are multiple features in the translations view which are interesting, and I would like to show you. One of the features is the translation memory, for example, which I didn't show you before because the project was empty. So here you can see, for example, for the app title free, which has the same translation or the same base text for English. So for app title 2, it's My Cool App, and for app title 3, it's also My Cool App. So in the translation memory, you can see that there is 100% match with the app title 2, which tells us that we can probably pretty safely use the same translation for app title 3. So that's translation memory. And also I can see the history for the translation. So I can see everything which changed in the past in the specific German translation of the string, which might be interesting when you want to explore what happened in the past. Another pretty important feature is the tags. So I can tag my keys. I can say, for example, this is on home page. I can say this is used for mobile, or this is used, for example, for web. I can basically utilize the tags as I want. I can give the key as many tags I want, and I can use it later. With the CLI tool, with the Tolgee CLI, I can select some keys by the tags for the export. I can filter the keys by tags, and I can export just these. It's pretty useful. I can also filter by tags here in the filters. So I can, for example, tag only the home keys. You can utilize it as you wish. Another feature which might be important for you is screenshots. So for example, if you would like to import screenshot for human translators for the future, you can do it by, for example, you can manually create screenshot of your screen, and then you can basically select the screenshot here by using this, and now I can see that the screenshot was uploaded here. So when the translator comes to the app, they can see where the string is in the app, which is usually pretty useful for the translators. In the translations view, you can also choose from various filters. Apart from tags, you can change by missing translation. So if there's a key with missing translation, which is I have everything translated now, but if I, for example, removed This one, I can now see everything with missing translation. So now the Spanish key with missing translation is visible here. Or I can see strings with outdated translation. I can show you how it works. For example, if I'm gonna change this English key to something else, like for example, I'm gonna change add to create, for example. Now, this German string was flagged as outdated because I changed the base value, but I didn't change the specific language value accordingly. So now I have this outdated flag, and as a translator, I can basically change it here. I can hit save, and when I updated the string, it's not outdated anymore. So this filter works for the outdated translations. I can select keys with no screenshots or with screenshots, and then I can select strings in specific state or with specific translation. Cool, so that's probably it from the translations view. Another feature I would like to show you is the tasks feature. So what I can also do in the project is that I can assign specific people to translate specific strings. I can select the tasks from the menu, go into the project tasks, and I can create new task here. I can basically select the type of the task, so if it's review or translate, and I can assign the right person for it. So this can be useful if you would like to delegate the translation job to other team members. In the languages page, I can configure the languages, I can add new language or delete languages, I can also configure the machine translation. And in the AI customization, I can customize the AI Tolgee translator to give better results. If you would like to watch a special video about Tolgee AI translator, follow this link. In the members section, you can configure your members. So you can invite users to the project, or you can manage permissions for current users. So for example, you can invite user via email, or you can send them a link. And you can configure basic level-based permissions, or you can configure the granular permissions. So you can also set up that one user have just permissions for specific granular operations. In the export section, you can export to the data into various formats. One of the great features of Tolgee is that you can export the data into different formats than you imported them. So if you have a web app, then you would like to use the same keys for mobile app in Android or iOS, you can use the same project for that, and you can export into different formats. Similar tool is content delivery, which means that you, instead of exporting the keys to download it to your computer, you can also push the data to the content, to the global CDN. We call it content delivery. And in the global CDN, the data are replicated around the world. Machines of your customers or users can download the data directly from the CDN, and you don't have to basically rebuild your app or republish your mobile app to get data to the users. So we have the same configuration elements, but it's not going to be downloaded, it's going to be published to the global CDN. So just to show you, we can fill some simple name. So this is going to be my CDN, for example. We're going to export all the states, we can hit save. And now when we hit publish, we got all the data published to the CDN with this prefix. So to get my English translations, I can just type the suffix in, and here I have the data exported in JSON format. I can also configure my custom content storage. So if I don't want to use the Tolgee CDN and I would like to provide my own S3 bucket or Azure Blob storage, I can do it here. Or I can also set up my custom webhooks. So if I have a service and I want the service to react to events in Tolgee, I can use this webhooks feature. Integrate page is useful when you would like to integrate Tolgee with your application. So we have, for example, native SDKs for React. So in this integrate page, you can get some simple step-by-step guide to integrate Tolgee into your React project. I just select my API key, and then I have this integrate steps, how to integrate Tolgee into my React project. And we have this for multiple technologies. And the last thing to show you is the project settings, where I can set my application name, I can set the description, even in Markdown, or I can, for example, leave the project or delete it or transfer to different organization. Okay, thanks for watching. If you would like to stay updated, just hit the subscribe button. Bye-bye.